Real ass bitch, give a fuck about a nigga.
I feel like you single, but we go together. So how would you feel about me telling people that I'm single? Because we go together. I'm not laughing.
Yo, hold on.
It ain't no hold on.
We go together now?
Real bad. Okay.
Whatever you say.
Like real that. Ass bitch, give a fuck about a nigga.
Oh, Christian trying to join her. Let Christian in. Yeah, Christian got a hit. Oh!
Real ass bitch, give a fuck about a nigga.
Your smile, your voice creeps inside my heart with everything it do.
Ooh.
I have ooh. No choice.
Ooh.
Loving you is ooh. All that I know how to do. Even when your weight was heavy, you were sorting me up. Even when you were in pieces, you would hold me together. Even though I was your baby, you was all the fight in me. One that was there to hold my back. Don't you know that I choose you over anybody else? When you're not around, it's just bad for my health. I'm good on my own, but with you I'm something else. You're telling me to choose up, but I already choose you.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Alex. Shout out to the Elite Fleet. Make sure you like and subscribe so you can become a member of the Elite Fleet. And we gotta talk about the city girls and the cap and how whole culture and thought culture is selling a false dream to these women. It's all cap, ladies. I need y'all, ladies and gentlemen, to understand. Because ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna speak to both of y'all in this video. I need y'all to understand. It's cap. City girls is cap. Thought culture, cap. Whole culture, cap. First of all, I don't even know how y'all listen to them. Because every time they rap, all I hear like this. They sound like straight mice to me. They sound like Alvin and the Chipmunks. That's all I hear when they rap. Tweety Bird, that's all I hear. So I don't understand how y'all listen to them. But either way, they selling y'all a wolf ticket. They selling y'all a dream. It's all cap. All these women say scam these dudes. All these women say get over on these dudes. And none of them are actually doing it. Now let's really get analytical and break this thing down. Now, before anybody says it, yes, I seen the video from Young Miami, where Young Miami was like, I don't know why y'all think that was about Diddy, and I don't know why everything gotta be about me. Like, y'all really think I will be weak in the knees over a man? First of all, yes, because not only do I have a lot of homegirls, but my last relationship was almost a year ago now, but I was in it soon enough to actually remember this.
I'm scared because I know that, you know, JT in jail and I'm supposed to be out here holding down the group and, you know, you and Coach been going so hard, making sure we get everything done and I don't know, like, I'm pregnant.
Yeah, that's you, pregnant, your baby daddy, in jail, and you crying. So yeah, you would be weak in the knees over a man. Also, by the way, quick gem for the ladies. If you ever call a man and tell a man that you pregnant, and his response is, you pregnant, just know you about to be a single mother. I told my ex that when she showed me that video, and lo and behold, Young Miami is a single mother dealing with Sugar Diddy, and Sugar Diddy got to having a mental breakdown because Sugar Diddy already got a new chick, and now she's like, oh, goddamn, my cash cow might leave. I might get kicked off of Revolt TV. Yeah, real bad. So yes, you do get sprung real bad, as you would say, real bad off of dudes. So at the end of the day, that mental breakdown might not have did nothing with Diddy. Maybe she's overworked. A lot of women, they want to do this boss girl stuff. They want to take on these high roles at jobs, but at the end of the day, it kind of goes against their nature to work that hard. Sometimes they do have mental breakdowns. Sometimes it does become too much. Maybe she did just need a break from work. Maybe it's the kids. She is a single mom. So maybe it's the kids. Maybe that's what was stressing her out. Maybe it didn't have anything to do with Diddy at all. But at the end of the day, she's still pushing that new whole thought culture narrative of, oh, scam these dudes, get the money from these dudes, get the bag from these dudes, but don't be in a relationship with these dudes, when at the end of the day, you hurt over and dealing with men all the goddamn time. I repeat, you're hurt over and dealing with men all the goddamn time. And let's go into thing two, dumber of dumb and dumber, and that's JT. JT out here booed up a little Uzi Vert, but then again, like I said, she was telling y'all, I'm a real ass chick, give a damn about that nigga, and all that other extra stuff, but she up here making reels all booed up all in this man's face. Now, is little Uzi Vert making reels about her? Of course not. I highly doubt that little Uzi Vert even cares about her, because again, I just got out of my relationship almost a year ago now. It has not been that long. So I seen the videos of her and Lil Uzi Vert. And let me tell you something. How Lil Uzi Vert talks to JT, all that city girls, I'm a boss chick, nonsense, be out the goddamn window. All that talk, out the window. Lil Uzi Vert talks to her like she's absolutely nothing. Lil Uzi Vert talks to her like she doesn't mean anything. So I don't think that's gonna last. I hope it do. She seems happy. I hope it works out for her, but most likely it's not going to. But if you watch how JT carries herself with Lil Uzi Vert and then what she portrays in the Matrix and the media to these young women, you can clearly see that ain't the same person. It's cap. It's all cap. So I have two messages that I want to get out here, okay? And we're going to start with the fellas. First of all, do not let these girls gas y'all up. Y'all got to understand 90% of what comes out of women's mouths is cap in general, but especially on the internet. Women like to gas up on the internet. 90% of the time, they just teasing y'all. 90% of the time, they just talking junk. They go out here and talk about how they going to scam. They go out here and talk about how they strong and independent and they don't need no man. They running through dudes' pockets and they doing all this other extra stuff and they're not doing nothing. Somebody got them crying at night. Somebody got them weak in the knees at night. Somebody got them reevaluating their whole goddamn life. Somebody got them acting like a housewife in the apron. And I keep telling you guys this. Not only do I show you, but I keep telling you guys this. You could talk that cap about modern women not being submissive all you want. They might not do it for you, but somebody got their ass in the kitchen, in the apron, cooking and cleaning and whipping up bricks in the kitchen. And by bricks, I mean bricks of slices of macaroni and cheese and not bricks of cocaine. Somebody got their ass being submissive. Somebody got their ass sprung. I don't give a damn what they say to you. I don't give a damn what they say to you. So it's no reason to take them serious. That talk is just that. It's talk. It's false bravado. These women, 90% of them want a man at the end of the day. And let me tell you something. Even if they're talking that feminist talk, if you pay attention to the most popping feminists, 90% of them are not married. I repeat, you pay attention to the most popping feminists, 90% of them are married. So they come out here and they sell that. They sell it to you. That's game. That's game at the end of the day. They're not taking that serious. That's a persona. That's a fake person. Just like I tell you guys about these MGTOW red pill dudes. These dudes tell you, oh yeah, don't ever get in a relationship with women. And then they be on their YouTube channel with Honor Lex, picking her up from the store. They in a whole relationship. These MGTOW dudes, same thing. Oh yeah, don't deal with these women. Don't deal with these women. Then they be tricking on these women and seeking arrangements, dealing with women behind your back. Semen retention dudes. Oh, don't deal with these women. Stay away from women. And then they be out here relapsing left and right. It's all cap. It's all cap. And then my secondary message, this message is for the ladies. Ladies, do not let the Matrix get you caught up out here. Do not let the Matrix put you into a situation that you can't get out of. Do not let the Matrix make you believe that scamming men, getting over on men, trying to use men like they quote unquote use you is gonna work. At the end of the day, your body don't work the same as ours. I repeat, at the end of the day, your body don't work the same as ours. You're more susceptible to STDs than we are in terms of soul ties. Men push, women pull. The vagina is a portal, the vagina is a vertex. Therefore, men are pushing all their issues into you. They're pushing all their insecurities onto you. They're pushing all their problems onto you. You're the one who gets pregnant. And at the end of the day, mama's baby, daddy's maybe. Not only because we not know who got you pregnant and you could be lying about it, but also because society's going to force you to take care of that kid. He could step. And at the end of the day, no matter how much he gives you in child support, it doesn't replace the void that's going to be in your kid from not knowing their father. Nor does it help you as far as the doctor's office visits. Nor does it help you as far as tutoring in the schoolwork. Nor does it help you as far as taking care of this child every single day, feeding this child, bathing this child, teaching this child right from wrong. So they can give you a check. I don't give a damn if the check is $10,000. At the end of the day, you're still going to be screwed. And as far as this whole scamming thought culture and get a check and sugar daddy culture and all this other extra stuff, listen, a man cheating on you is the last thing you got to worry about. Yo, Miami should be happy that all Diddy got is another chick, because a lot of these chicks is winding up dead. See Miss Mercedes Moore. Got killed at her own house. Out here monetizing herself. See Tiger Booty. Got killed overseas, out here monetizing herself. And those are just two examples. See, they tell you about the glitz. They tell you about the money. They tell you about the bag you can get for monetizing yourself. But they don't tell you they be getting doo-dooed on in Dubai. They don't tell you that they be getting pissed on. They don't tell you about the mental health breakdowns. They don't tell you about the damn soul ties. They don't tell you that this working in a monetized field or sexualizing yourself or selling your body has the shortest career span ever. The only career span even comparable to the short length of being a sex worker or selling your body is an athlete. And athletes on average get 4.5 years. Sex workers get 2.5 years. There ain't no retirement plan. There ain't no 401k. There ain't no social security. So you better be investing that bag, flipping that bag, or finding somebody to marry you and save you at the end of it all. And you're going to have a hard time doing that. See Mia Khalifa. See Lana Rose. Even if you skip and you wipe out all your history from OnlyFans, all your pornos that you did, all those pictures that you pointed, at the end of the day, the internet's forever. Kim K thought she wiped out all her sex tapes with Ray J. You can go on Reddit right now and pull that right up. Once you post something on the internet, it's never gone. So you got to hope that you're able to secure a man, because the sex work's not gonna last. The monetization's not gonna last. At a certain point, you're gonna get old. A newer, younger, finer chick gonna pop up. And this is assuming you don't get aged like Gina too. This is assuming that you don't pop up dead or missing like Miss Mercedes Moore or like Tiger Booty. This is assuming, shoot, Meg almost died living that monetized lifestyle. And Meg is another liar, because Meg got a whole boyfriend out here. Another one who be telling y'all to scam on these dudes, to play these dudes, to get the money out of these dudes. But she in a whole relationship right now. But before she was in that relationship, what was she doing? She was out here riding the cock carousel, and what happened? She ended up jumping on a D that her friend was already on, and her friend let off that ratchet on her, bat, bat, had her dancing like Yosemite Sam. Her friend had Meg Thee Stallion like this. Dance! So, ladies, you gotta understand, they're not gonna tell you the dark side. Just like I say to the dudes all the time, they're gonna make scamming dudes look cool. They're gonna make having sugar daddies look cool. They're gonna make monetizing yourself look cool. They're gonna make being strong and independent look cool. But at the end of the day, they're not doing any of that. You got Beyonce out here. Beyonce out here telling these girls, oh yeah, be a loose church girl. Oh yeah, drop it like a thotty. But at the end of the day, Beyonce is married. She's capped too. All these girls is capped. Beyonce married talking that stuff. At the end of the day, Jay-Z done cheated on Beyonce like 6, 7, 8 something times. And the worst she did was send Shalons to give him that 2-piece and a biscuit. That's the worst she did. She sat her ass right there and was embarrassed. But she's still with her man. You gotta understand, Young Miami has a man. Megan Thee Stallion has a man. Beyonce has a man. JT has a man. All these women have a man. Hell, even Brittany Renner tried to settle down. So you could buy into that whole thing if you want to. Again, most feminists who run their mouth the most, who have the biggest platforms, they're married. They have a man. So you can let the matrix, you can let society, you can let the system trick you into, oh yeah, you don't meet no man, you can do it all by yourself. And then when your ass is 40 and your body start breaking down, and you start tripping out, and you like, God damn, man, I really wish I had some help. I really wish I had some support. I wish I had some help with these kids. I wish I had somebody support me in general. I wish I wasn't in this house by myself with these cats and with these dogs. It's going to be too late. Do not let the matrix get you with the cat. At the end of the day, as human beings, we are social creatures. At the end of the day, as human beings, we all going to want to be with somebody. If you're LGBTQ, that's fine. You're still with somebody. But my point is the likelihood, some of us are introverts. Some of us can be happy alone. But the vast majority of people, they're not going to be happy like that. And most of these women selling you those tickets, it's just that. It's tickets. It's cap. They're not really living like that. All these girls got men behind closed doors. And if they don't have men, they hoping for men. You don't want to be on Summer Walker's next track saying Sierra's prayer, praying that you can find a man at 40 something years old, washed up. You don't want to be a single mama too, hoping somebody come and save you. You got sugar diddy. You don't want to be in a situation like that. So at the end of the day, it's all gas, it's all cap. Again, fellas, understand, these women be capping. They just be talking stuff. They don't really live what they rap about. Ladies, understand, all these girls are lying to you. It's all cap. They don't really live how they talking. They just talking. Do not fall for the cap. Do not fall for the matrix scam. Open your eyes. See what's happening around you. All of this is an agenda. None of it's real. The metaverse is fake. I repeat, the metaverse is fake. So do what you do. Don't do what's trendy. Again, right now, everything that's trendy, it's a pill people selling you to make money. They're not doing none of that behind closed doors. Behind closed doors, all these girls, they have boyfriends, they have husbands, they're in a relationship. Behind closed doors, all these gurus, they got girlfriends. They dealing with women. They're in relationships. It's all cat. It's all cat. They trying to keep y'all miserable and depressed and separated. Do not fall for it. But that's just my thoughts on that. I am Malix and I am out. Peace.